So back with my princess in Melbourne, and we're just going to go for some breakfast. Breakfast, honey. It was good? Beautiful day here in Melbourne. It's good to be back in town and back at home, and gonna go out for a ride this afternoon and try and get some K's in and get ready for the summer crits. So the summer crits everywhere else in the world, it's sort of edging into winter now, but in here in Australia we're sort of moving towards summer. So it's a beautiful day. We've got a beautiful weekend lined up, and gonna try and start getting fit for the Criterium season, which is starting this Sunday at St Kilda. So that's the first race of the season. And so really looking forward to getting some GoPro footage on that. It's about 4:30 p.m. now, so only just getting out on the bike. But heading out to do this little bad boy a couple of times. Out at the Dandenongs, just outside of Melbourne. It's a beautiful day here in Melbourne, and I'm just coming up to an awesome little climb. It's called Devil's Elbow. You can see it here on the map. Quite a tough climb. Any climb's a tough climb for me though. It's aptly named Devil's Elbow, mind you. But I was gonna take you through the whole climb with the camera, but I was hurting so bad I couldn't even get the camera out of my pocket. So just heading down Sherbrooke Road now. And you can see that on the map. Gonna do another climb, and then not sure from there, but we'll see how we go. This next climb is called the Wall. It's not called the Wall for no reason. It's a tough climb. The first 5K is pretty steep, and then it sort of plateaus off after that. So it's really, really good climb to test yourself. So this is the left turn, Alinda Mumbok Road, and then this is the start of the Wall. So it's not too bad for the first few hundred meters, but then it sort of steepens up a bit through the midsection and ends up plateauing off towards the end. So you can really ramp it up speed-wise. Not this little black duck though. So just rode down the 1:20, absolute stunning ride. I wish I had the GoPro on, because it's such a good roll down that hill. I love going downhill, but I don't like going uphill. So yeah, just rolling home now along the footpath. There's this awesome footpath, you'll see it here on Strava, and you just follow that around, and that's sort of your warm down, I suppose, and then you just roll back into the city. So if you're not from Melbourne and you want to try Dandenong's Roll, I think that's a good one to try for maybe your first outing. There's a few others as well that I'll link in the description of the YouTube description down below. But it's a nice little path, this one. So one thing about this time of year is there's a lot of magpies swooping, bike riders, and there's a lot of bees out. I just had a, because it's spring, I had a bee just hit me in the face and it landed under my arm, and I didn't know until it just stung me just then, so felt this sharp pain. But there's a lot of magpies out at the moment. You'll see a lot of dudes, a lot of people riding around with cable ties sticking out of their helmet. Mate, honestly, there is no need to do that. It looks horrendous. Ding ding. Thanks. So there is no, absolutely no need to put cable ties in your helmet. The helmet is protection enough from the magpies, and we'll just wear some sunglasses and you'll be fine. If you put cable ties on your helmet, you just look like a dickhead. That's the only purpose it serves. So I did a blog post about this quite a while ago, and I think a lot of people will agree with me. So yeah. Just getting home now, nearly 3.5 hours on the bike. It's getting dark, but still absolutely stunning out, beautiful weather, and it was a good session.